She was born in Cork under the Shannon clock, while the bells played hallelujah. She was baptized Mary Harris in the good old North Chapel in the autumn of 1837. She grew up badly with her family, surrounded by sickness and poverty. She saw the poor being robbed by those who were well off, and she never forgot those memories. She sailed away to America, where her family had to hide of the famine. They met there for the dare who walked on the railway, and they all moved to Toronto, Canada. They settled down in the fur trading town, where Mary became a teacher. She taught all the kids to respect what they did, especially the poor and the sick. She was born underneath the Shannon clock as the bells played hallelujah. She fell in love with a Memphis man by the name of George Jones. They married in Tennessee, had four children, the best you could see, but the fever took them all in the sleep. She rambled around from town to town, trying to cope with the loss of a family. She got a job dressmaking for the well-to-do ladies, but the poor on the streets were calling. She was born underneath the Shannon clock as the bells played hallelujah. She joined the Knights of Labor to help get things better for the workers and their families. She took to the streets to protest all their needs, but police locked her up in the nick. She was called Murder Jones for the good work she had done by the miners of America. Roosevelt once said he had a pain in his head over a woman called Murder Jones. She was born underneath the Shannon clock as the bells played hallelujah. She passed away at a good old age, still fighting for the rights of the workers. Her last words she said, "I never will be dead as long as there is injustice." She was born underneath the Shannon clock as the bells played hallelujah. She gave her life for those who could not fight hallelujah. Hallelujah.